1980s was the decade where everything was big and proudly on display, from hair to shoulder pads. But for many in the LGBT community, they had to live in the shadows. And it's the focus of a new series called Pose, which looks at the ballroom culture of New York in the 80s. Have a look.
Focus, children. It is time we remind the world who we are.
And that is how you do a ball.
Oh, it looks absolutely fabulous. And we have from Pose, Indya Moore and Dominique Jackson. Welcome to the studio. Hello, lovely. How are you?
Good to see you.
I'm so happy to be here.
Oh, you both smell so beautiful.
Thank you for being on a live television show.
Feel at least 20% cooler.
Now, tell us all about Pose. It looks fantastic. It looks so glossy and just fabulous. It's all about ballrooms and house culture in New York in the 80s.
Well, ballroom culture was about people who were ostracized from their families. And we had to find a place where we could exist, where we could feel like we belonged, where we could appreciate each other and uplift each other. And so it was about the different categories. And these different categories tapped into the many talents that so many people had that they had to, they could not express. So there are categories like the face category, which is about not about beauty, but more about how you sell it. No matter how you look, you still believe that you're so magnificent. You can carry it like that. The runway category. And, of course, the now avatar for the ballroom scene, which is voguing.
Yeah.
And why was it known as the sort of ballroom scene? It's because it was so grandiose and over the top and big? Or what was the kind of the reason behind the thing?
Well, when Crystal LaBeija lost one of the drag pageants, she decided that because she was of color, it was something that we needed to express, to have in our own community. Right. And so, therefore, we had to go big or go home.
Right.
And then from these drag balls, many others came in, and then men started to participate. And it became this grandiose thing. And, of course, when you're marginalized and you're facing prejudice and discrimination, this was a way to find your happiness.
The best defense is a good offense.
Yes, of course.
I love this part of New York's history, this part that gave us the ballroom culture, Jean-Michel Basquiat, Keith Haring, Warhol was around at that time. It was a really fertile period that Ryan Murphy, who's the creator of this, who's the Midas touch with Glee and Feud, and apparently when he saw you two and he thought, cast, that's it. I want you. Was the audition process as simple as that?
Actually, no. The casting was set out for everyone. He wanted everyone to have the opportunity to be able to showcase themselves, to be able to audition for the part. And what happened is when, for myself personally, when I walked in, when I saw the sides, the script, I realized that this was the embodiment of all those women who created this scene, like Avis Pendarvis, Pepa LaBeija, Pepa Ori Montana, Danielle Revlon, Octavia St. Laurent, you know, Paris Dupree. So these women and what they did, I knew that because I had the opportunity to hear their stories personally, that I could deliver. And I did my best. I did my research. And I wanted to deliver the best lecture that I possibly could as in honor to those women. Right.
I'm so staring at your beautiful makeup and your hair. Tell us as well about why this is such a groundbreaking show, because it really does, well, it knocks down a lot of barriers. You both have incredible backstories as well that you're bringing to the show. Tell us about that.
Well, there's a couple things at work when it comes to Pose. First of all, it brings an experience of a marginalized group of people to the to the perspective, to the bedrooms, and to the homes of people who are otherwise not in proximity to these people. So it gives people a really good understanding of what the lives are like of folks that they're not in proximity to. Also, it's incredible because it demonstrates to people around the world who are like us, who are rejected from their homes and the rest of society because of who they are, an idea of how they can come together and create their own space, their own world.
There are more than 50 transgender characters, that's right, in this movie, in this series?
Mr. Murphy has employed over 150, I believe, people that are from the ballroom scene.
Wow.
And many of us happen to be trans.
Wow. Good.
Trans people are really coming to the fore at the moment, which is a great thing to say. In many ways, it's sort of the last great frontier of inequality. There was a huge controversy, as you would know, about Scarlett Johansson being cast to play a trans woman. I just wonder, what did you think about that? Do you think that trans actors should be employed to play trans people, or do you think it's something that a straight woman can play, or what are your thoughts?
As an actor, you have to be able to have the diversity, the ability to be able to play any character and to make that character as authentic to all and real to all those people that are watching. So for those that don't know about it, you want them to be able to try to understand it. And for those that have lived it, you want them to feel honored by it. So it's not about who plays the character, it's about the ability to bring that authenticity, because I would be a hypocrite to knock that, because I don't only want to play trans roles.
Yes, exactly right.
I'd also like to add that, you know, trans people don't get hired, and there's so much trans talent, right? So I think if anyone's going to be able to tell our stories the best way, it would be, right, trans people. So, I mean, it just makes no sense for someone who, you know, wants to take on a story and tell it and bring it to the world to not utilize the people of these experiences to tell them.
It's and time for the like, casters to search out.
Right. And then it's like also that dynamic where, like, you know, not only are we more than capable of telling our own stories, but it's just, you know, trans people are disenfranchised. We're not being hired, you know what I mean, to tell our stories. So it's really important, you know.
I suppose as Dominique was saying, that, but you guys also want to be able to play roles that aren't trans as well, so.
Yeah, we don't always want to play roles that are, like, about dissecting, you know, gender. Like, we hear a lot about, like, trans people. We want to play cis roles. I think what we're trying to communicate is that we want to play roles that don't dissect gender and that are just about life outside of our genders. Because when we look at TV shows and film featuring cis talent, are we talking about, you know, people's sex parts? Are we talking about, like, we're not dissecting we're just utilizing these vessels, right? These people to tell the stories that are written for them to perform.
Do you think this series will see a big resurgence in voguing?
Well, voguing has actually been quite large. It's actually gone global. We have people that are coming from Asia, from all over the world.
Can anyone vogue?
Anyone can vogue.
Can you show us how to vogue? What do we do?
I've never been able to vogue.
So we keep it feminine.
Okay.
So, hand here, hand here, bring it around, out here, circle it a little, serve the face.
Strike a pose, there's nothing to it. Vogue.
It's basically like a sequence of like modeling poses.
Yeah.
It's
like, I love.
You know, you're like pose, right? So it's just like, so those shapes and experimenting
like
with all those.
Let my body go.
Paris Dupree expressed it best, God bless her soul. And Vogue was a series of poses that would become this movement. And what happened as we moved along was that those of us that are female, you know, whether it's in mind, spirit, or or in body, believe that we didn't want to do those straight lines that they were doing in Madonna's Vogue. So we feminized it. We made it softer. We made it more fluid, more movement.
More glamorous. Now, Pose screens on Fox Showcase, and it's streaming on Foxtel on Tuesdays at 8:30. Dominique and Indya, you are just gorgeous, both of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.